There's one thing I don't love about Trello, and it's that checklist items are so close to being so powerful, but they're just not quite there. And one of the things that I struggle with is viewing all of the checklist items. There's a couple ways around it. You've got your home view where you can see your upcoming checklist items. You can kind of see them in calendar views, but it only works in the board calendar view and not workspace, and it doesn't work in timeline view. And then you get my favorite thing, which is building automations to convert checklist items to linked cards, which I find really fun, but most people don't, and I will admit it's probably a step more than ideally we should be doing. All of this kind of sounds like a little bit of pain to most people, so I tend to steer them to focusing on cards and not checklist items, until I discovered this power-up that actually makes checklist items super useful. It's the Checklist Summary Power-Up by MIG, and I'm going to tell you all about it. But first of all, I want to introduce myself. My name is Brittany Joyner. I've been using Trello for about a decade, and I'm obsessed with it. I have a newsletter where every week I share tips, tricks, and best practices to help you use Trello better. I have this YouTube channel where I create content, and I even wrote a book about Trello. So if you're thinking about getting into Trello or you're already into it, you have found the right place. Stick around to the end of this video. I'm going to show you some more of my favorite power-ups and which ones you should be adding to your boards. But let's go ahead and jump right in to this checklist summary power-up. So from any board, when you want to explore power-ups, click this rocket ship icon up here and go ahead and click add power-up. It's going to take you to this power-up directory. You can search for different things or view categories. I'm looking for this checklist summary here, and you can see this one comes up. When you want to explore a power-up, click within it and you can see more about it. You can see how many boards it's in. So you can, on this page, kind of get more of an idea of what's going on. I'm going to actually show you all this, so we'll skip through this, but you can learn more about pricing, how it works, and who to contact if you have any questions. If you're sold on it, go ahead and click add, and you'll be prompted to walk through and actually add it to your board. Once it is added, you will see it pop up over here, and it's a new item in your board. Now, I've already authorized before. You may have to go through an authorization flow. Just connect your Trello account. No big deal, super easy to do. So from here, you're gonna be able to view all of your checklists items across multiple boards. If you don't see anything, you may not have checklists in a card. So to do that, just open up a card and click checklist and add, and go ahead and add new checklist item. And now you have a checklist item. You can assign it to someone. You can give it a due date. Do whatever you would like with it. And so now we're gonna click that checklist again, and this is a table of all of your checklist items across all places. Each row effectively equals a checklist item, and you can interact with it by clicking here to actually set a due date on those items. You can click here to assign people, so that's really cool as well. You can also filter things, so maybe I just wanna see mine. You can click to filter and see who you want to show here. You can also search for names here and a keyword, so if you're looking for all that include task or something like that. And you can really just get this bird's eye view and also see what you need to see. So you can also hide completed ones. So maybe I actually don't care about ones that have already been completed if I've already done this one. I can go ahead and once I check that off, it's gonna disappear. That's the other thing, you can complete them from here, which is really cool. You can sort them by due date. So let's say you wanna see what's coming up next versus what is, you know, all over the board here. And you can also group them. So this is really cool, and I didn't notice this at first, but you can group a column. So let's say, for instance, you wanna group by who is assigned to ones, right? So I can see, oh, these are all Brittany's, and oh, these are all unassigned that I probably need to go assign to somebody, or yeah, whatever you want to do with that. So that's super cool. I thought that was pretty neat. By default, again, it just starts out with this current board, but if you click up here, you can select all sorts of different boards. I think this is an amazing feature because, again, you cannot in any other way group all of your checklist items across multiple boards that I know of. So this is super useful. This is a really great power-up. And if you're not sure, should I be using checklists? I love using checklists because it's a great way to chunk out your tasks. So let's say you've got this whole bulky thing going on here, right? Like, I need to write a book. Well, that's a really bulky task. And research shows that if you make a task too big, your brain literally just can't wrap its mind around how to do it. So I like adding a checklist so I can say something like draft an outline, and then write chapter one, and then maybe review chapter one, and et cetera. And as you add those sort of things, it helps you have little milestones that you can check along the way to make progress and help you move forward on your goal. It's also fantastic if you're collaborating with people on a project. You've got your whole to-do list here. You're probably using this for projects for work, like making proposals or things like that, but I'm just using this example so you can see what it looks like to add different people and different dates so you can kind of sort out, okay, here's the overall project, here's the specific steps of what needs to happen within it, and being able to delineate by dates and owners. So this power-up is really cool, but if you're looking for even more power-ups to add to your boards, check out this list. I'm going to include it in the video description. It's a board that shows you all of my favorite power-ups that will supercharge your board. So I have ones that are built by Trello, I have ones that are just generally useful across no matter how you're using Trello, and then I've got ones that I like to call are situationally helpful, and all sorts of great things in here. There's ones I recommend for reporting, and again, I just encourage you to go through these and check them all out and click the links, and you can go straight to their listing in the PowerUp directory and learn more about them, how you might want to use them, and why. Most of these have at least free versions to let you try them out and see if they're useful and if they're going to help you in the process, so you can validate them. So before you leave, make sure to head over to one of your Trello boards and add the checklist summary power-up. Explore my recommended power-ups after that, and then subscribe to my newsletter for more Trello content. It's free, and there's no reason to not just get more Trello in your life. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.